Ooh, this post chorus is stanky. One more time, for good measure. Hey, I'm John. I'm a traveling pop producer, traveling the country all year and making music along the way. Great to have you here today. And I'm so excited to bring my pop production perspective into this song. I've listened through to the album up to this song, so I have some perspective. But if you want to hear the whole album, let me know. Like, if you want us to go through together and I could talk through as we listen together, let me know. Would love to do that. But I have stopped short of Sacrifice. It is the most listened to song on the album so far, and I wanted to go through it together for the first time. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. I will be pausing it a lot. I was born. Already loving the way that funk grooves with swing. I mean, most funk has swing to it. It's a very heavy swing. So you have 1, 2, 3, boom, up. Like you're kind of delaying that last, bump. That last beat, so you get a little bit of the anticipation, and then you get the grounding on the one. Like that really quick double hit. That feels great. I'm already excited to hear where this goes. His vocal is nice and tucked in, but I know they jump out. They're teasing us. Great reverb throws. Okay, so we went back to a second verse, but one thing that I think is really important is when I approach making music, I'm very focused on what I call the banger four. And the banger four is a 4-bar loop of a song that feels incredible, that feels perfect, almost done. And when you focus on that, you get stuff like this guitar loop concept that they put together. Boom, ba-dum, bum, dum, 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 ba-dum, 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 ba-dum. Like it's just going the whole time. And then your foundation of your song ebbs and flows over those couple of elements that you establish in this first section of the song. And I have a feeling that this motif is going to continue through the whole song, as well as the feel of this groove, because it's funk. And just things develop around that. But that's what happens, and like you focus on those fundamentals like that. You're back to square one. Drums, guitar loop, little one vocal, and then we're back up. The vocal. Those sides are loud. Yeah, okay, interesting. Ooh, I love how the chord. That reminds me of Kiss Me More. Kiss Me More. Like the way that the chords hit in that song, it's a similar thing where 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, the whole band hits on a couple of accents in the phrasing. That bend is dope. Sounds like the thing from the verse. But the man just kept on a pitch. Anybody notice how the double is actually, there's no center vocal there in this whole second verse. It's a dry take, two dry takes, panned out, no center vocal compared to here. But there's one in the middle. Oh, that's really dope. I love that because then it's going to kind of make us feel a little more detached, and then they bring it back in with the center vocal down the line. And also, pay attention to this little detail. You're going to need headphones or catch stereo for this. But so that fuzz right there. So it pans a little on the right, left, right, left, right, left. So just little things, right? We're always having the ear be tickled with the ear candy and different stuff like that. Same drum fill, but we got the pause. Then it came in. Oh, it's interesting. Because in this pre-chorus, right, like he's singing very round. I try to stand on. He's not doing his like super poppy breath trebly tone. But then you can even hear how bright his I can't. Very round. Very bright. And then back to the bright tone. Adding more harmonies on the response vocals. Wait. A little more than last time. Getting a nice pause there and the groove comes back in. Really good. Couple of ad-libs, beautiful. But again, let's break this down. This song at its core, drum groove, bass line, guitar loop, big chord stabs, couple of percussion layers. That's the core of it. There's a lot more that goes into a pop song than that, but like the foundation is quite direct and simple when it is all so damn good sound. Super Michael Jackson vibes right here. I love that. Nice. Oh, that's great. And again, right, I feel like stuff like this is what really separates the technicians from the hobbyists, because it's the detail in lines like this and transitions like this. We're getting those vocal stacks on just the word time. Because he could have just done on my time, or whatever the heck he's doing. Or just had one or two things there, but they built it out. So then when it rips away from them, do the ho, it kind of feels a little more hollow and empty. And then the beat comes in. So if it's just his lead vocal, it wouldn't be as dramatic. It wouldn't be as intricate. It wouldn't be as exciting. And this just builds it out in such an incredible way where then you get the big, you get the small, and then they go and just whip it right back at you. And I love that feeling. One more time for good measure. Ooh, this post-chorus is stanky. Notice how they just kept some of the harmony layers going on there. They didn't keep all the layers, just some of the response vocals. So left room for the, I don't wanna sacrifice. That's nice. I tried. Oh, there's nothing there. Oh, so they just kept one of the four lines on the chorus and then left the rest open for the reprise. That's really dope. And I like the processing. Like, it's very thin and centered. And then the response vocals are still freaking massive, bangaroony, hugeness on the sides. Again, that contrast, that we can't have everything be huge, otherwise nothing's huge. And that's obviously a restraint that a refined team at this level is going to understand very, very well. And I was right, this guitar loop said the entire song. I don't think it ever left, unless it did for the bridge. No, it was there. Nice. Oh, man. Just an absolutely great song. So funky, so full, so rich, so captivating. I'm going to talk to a new artist about whose EP I'm doing is a lot of this funk disco pop. It's like your feet don't stop from bar one, and they will stop moving when the song is over. And they will never stop. They are always driving, and there's pauses, there's hits, there's things like that, but it's like we never lose the momentum, or if it's over dramatic with pausing and leaving too much space, because I want to get back to bump it up, and that's something that I think this song does really, really well. A lot of this levitating, really just like her whole Future Nostalgia album, Dua Lipa's, is it just does not stop you from moving. And I love that. So I hope you enjoyed my perspective. Thanks so much for being here. If you want me to talk about the whole album in depth, like we did with this song, let me know. And if there's interest, I will definitely bring that to you guys. Other than that, thanks again. Glad to have you here in the family. I will see you in that next video. Remember, you are always one song away. Cheers.